Hey, second grade, welcome back. Week two of our digital learning from home. I hope all you guys are doing great. Last week, we worked on and we talked about, as you can see, we the digital citizens, right? So we talked about how we could be good digital citizens, and we talked about what that meant. And this week, we're going to talk about device-free moments, okay? So it's good to see you guys. I'm glad we got started last week, and it's good to be back, even though it's different, not being in the computer lab, doing it from home. It's still fun. It's still good to see you guys. I look forward to seeing you guys again in office hours this week. This is our second lesson, so let's go ahead and get into device-free moments. Okay, so I'm going to start click present here. We've got media balance over here, and we've got arms of the digital citizens hanging from the tree. Why is it important to have device-free moments in our lives? Right, and we talked about what a device is. You guys know that. Why do you think it's important to have times where we're not on our devices? This is something I didn't have to worry about, guys. I didn't have these devices like you have. Didn't grow up having smartphones that were on the internet and tablets, and you could do everything anywhere you go and watch movies and play games. Didn't have that. Why do you think there should be times where you get away from that and you're device free? Think about it. I think it's really important to have times, to have moments where you're in real life. Because I really kind of consider the devices to be, it's real life, but it's different. So it's good to be device-free and have times where you're in real life and you're appreciating the moment, what's happening around you. Because when we're on our devices, we can kind of get lost in what's happening around us, right? Why is it, why do you know why? Why is it not okay for people to text and drive at the same time? These are laws that have gotten changed as we have more and more devices across the country. It's not legal anymore to be on your phone in different places while you're driving. It's unsafe, right? You can't pay attention to two things at once. Can't pay attention to traffic. And you don't want to have an accident. You don't want to hurt somebody because you're texting, right? So today we're going to talk about why it's important to have moments in our lives that are device free. So let's start by watching a funny movie about this topic, okay? Let's start by watching this.
Looks like it's device for dinner. What's for dessert?
So everybody on Sesame Street figured out that it's good to have some times without their devices. Now, if we were together, I would have you talk with a partner, but since we're doing it like this, let's just talk together. What'd you notice in that video? Are there moments where it would be better not to use devices? How about when you're at the movies? It's nothing worse than being at the movies and having somebody on their phone, right? How about if you're at some sort of religious service, right? You're at church or mosque or temple. Definitely not a time to use your devices. Family dinners, right before bed. These are all times where it's good to have a break and not be using devices. Just think about when you guys have been out at restaurants. Ever seen two people on a date? Sometimes they're not even talking to each other, guys, because they're both looking at their own phone. They're not even talking to each other. Those are times where they should be putting their devices away, taking a break. So there are definitely times when it's better not to use devices, right? Maybe you came up with some more times that would be good not to use them. And we can share that during our office hours time. So distraction, a distraction is something that keeps you from giving your full attention, right? And if you're on a device when there's other things you should be paying attention to, that's a distraction. And as a teacher, right, I'm always trying to help, and so are your other teachers, trying to help you learn and pay attention and focus and have as little distractions as possible. Now, that's going to be really tough during this time we're learning from home, because at home you can have all kinds of distractions. So it's going to be a challenge for us and for you to not be distracted while we're learning this way. Your attention, right? We want you to notice something or someone as important. Your attention, and it's important that you are able to take time and are able to concentrate and pay attention. Now, it's harder to do it for longer periods of time, but you really need to practice being able to really pay attention when someone is trying to teach you or tell you something. And part of that's being a good listener, right? That may be something that we talk about kind of as an extra thing here through digital learning. We may talk about being a good listener. Safety. Let's talk about this in 1 second here. Although every situation and every family is different, there are times in all of our lives when it's a good idea to have device-free moments. You also have to think of how being on a device affects those around you, because it can also affect our friends and family. So we're going to talk about a few things here to consider so that we can have more device-free moments, right? So let's start here with safety. There are times when you or someone else's safety could be at risk, like at times where you just should not have a device. Like if you're crossing the street. I've seen so many adults, guys, that are crossing the street looking at their phones. That is so dangerous because you're not paying attention. We are much smaller than cars, right? Cars are much tougher than we are. It's so silly. If it's something where you need to be safe, you should not be on your device, right? How about respect? There are times when it hurts other people's feelings if you're distracted and you're not paying attention to them. Like someone's trying to talk to you directly, or you're trying to talk to someone directly. If your friend is trying to tell you an important story, what should you do? Put down your device. Look at them. Listen. It's important to pause for people. Remember, we've talked already about pausing. It's important to pause for people. Concentration. There are times when you should give your full attention to a specific activity, and that means putting down your device. If you're reading a book, you're doing homework, you're doing some kind of arts and crafts, these are activities that require you to give your full attention. And if you have a device out, makes it harder to concentrate, not just for you guys, for me, for any adult, for anybody. sleep. There are quiet times, like when we're going to sleep, when our devices should be put away. Doctors recommend that people stop using devices at least an hour before bedtime, because that blue light in the screen can affect how well we sleep. It's a good idea to charge your devices away from where you sleep, not in your room, so that you're not tempted to use it right before bed. It's important to get your rest. As you guys get older, you're going to realize how important your rest is. Think about how you felt when you've gotten up and you've not gotten enough sleep. Sleep is really important, guys, to being healthy and happy. Okay. Today, you're going to get to be in charge. You're going to create a list of family rules to have device-free moments. This list of rules is not just for you, but also for your parents, your siblings, whoever else that lives with you, right? You're going to be able to share these with your family. Okay? So this is a time for you to reflect on your life. Okay? Everyone's family's different, so your rules might be different, right? So we're going to create a list of rules to help your family have device-free moments. Remember, the rules aren't just for you, but everyone you live with. Whoop, went back. You can write special rules for certain people. You can be the boss. You're in charge. So I'm going to have this up on this assignment up on our Google class, and you will be able to come up with your family's device-free rules, okay? So I will be posting that. You'll see that. Okay. Our pause and think moment for this week. I want you to take 10 minutes, draw me something. What advice would you give a grown-up to not be distracted by devices? What kind of advice would you give them? And then I want you to explain. I want you to write. I want you to explain the advice you would give and why. So what advice would you give a grown-up? How can they not be distracted by devices? And then why would you give them that advice? Okay. So I hope you've enjoyed lesson two of digital citizenship. Today we talked about device-free moments. And then I'm also going to have up on Google for you to work on your family's rules. Okay. So I look forward to seeing you in office hours this week. And I will talk to you and see you very, very soon. All right, Mr. Houston saying goodbye.